मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, यस्टरडे वी हैव स्टार्टेड द फर्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ साइंस वन, लॉज ऑफ मोशन. सो मेनी कंसेप्ट्स वी हैव कंसिडर्ड और स्टडीड यस्टरडे, दैट इज स्पीड, वेलोसिटी, डिस्टेंस, डिस्प्लेसमेंट एक्सेट्रा. नाउ द नेक्स्ट पार्ट दैट वी हैव टू स्टडी, सपोज टेक वन एग्जाम्पल, यू आर ड्राइविंग अ टू व्हीलर और बाइसिकल, वॉट सो एवर मे बी, द रोड इज वेरी प्लेन स्मूथ एंड यू आर riding the bicycle or any two wheeler, then there is no disturbance on the road or any pits on the road, then you are driving very smoothly, then your speed changes when you change your speed or increase your speed, means your velocity changes. That velocity changes when your speed changes on the smooth road, then that you know very well. If you are changing the direction of the vehicle on any road or there is any turn etc., then the speed remains same. It does not remain same, it changes, and as your speed changes, velocity also changes. Then you are changing the speed as well as the direction of your vehicle, then also velocity changes. So velocity depends on speed as well as the direction. Speed, you know, it doesn't require the direction, but velocity requires the direction. Now velocity depends on speed and direction. Just now I have told you that these points you have to write in your notebook. Velocity changes when it changes, you change the speed. Then velocity changes when you change the direction, you turn the vehicle, and it also changes when you change your speed as well as the direction of the vehicle, then also velocity changes. So velocity changes by changing the speed while keeping the direction same direction. In the straight forward way you are going, direction is same, you are not changing the direction, then your velocity changes by changing your speed only. Then changing the direction while keeping the speed same, you are changing the direction, but speed is same, then also velocity changes, and it also changes by changing the speed as well as the direction of the vehicle. Now this speed concept was first given by Galileo, that speed is nothing but distance upon time, that is given by Galileo. Now the speed of sound in dry air is 343.2 meter per second, and velocity or speed of the light is about 3×10⁸ meter per second. This can be asked for fill in the blanks etc. Again, one more concept, the revolution of the earth revolves around the sun, that you know very well, and its speed is 29,770 meter per second. So underline this, that can be asked in the filling the blanks in the question. So the velocity or the speed of the earth around the sun is 29,770 meter per second. Now one more concept we have to study. I have written on the board that the distance covered by these three fellows, Amar Akbar and Anthony, in kilometer, time in the clock, 5 o'clock, 5:30, 6, 6:30, 7, 7:30 and 8, means time interval you can understand. What is the time interval? Is of half an hour. Now Amar covers 5, they are starting at 5 o'clock, all these three, Amar, Akbar and Anthony, they are starting at 5 o'clock in the, and so the initial speed is 0. At 5:30, see the speed of Amar, 20 kilometer, 40 kilometer, 60 kilometer, 80 kilometer, 100 kilometer and 120 kilometer. But Akbar, he has covered the distance in first half an hour 18 kilometer, second half an hour 36 kilometer, third half an hour 42, then 70, then 95 and then 120. Again Anthony, 0 first, then 24, 14, 28, 42, 56, 70 and 84 kilometers. Are these three fellows covering same distance in same interval of time? Time interval is same for all these three, half an hour. can see from the table that Amar covers for every half an hour 20 kilometer distance. 20, the table of 20, 20, 40, 60, 80, 100 and 120. But Akbar, he has not covered the same distance in every half an hour. First half an hour at 80, then second 36, third 42, then 70, etc. Again, Anthony, 14, table of 14, 14, 28, 42, 56, 70 and 84. He has also covered equal distance in every half an hour. Now, you have to consider that the speed of these three fellows. Here, Amar and Anthony, they have covered equal distance in equal time intervals, and this is called the linear motion, uniform linear motion. That is, they are going in the straightforward way or on the straight road. But Akbar has not covered equal distance in equal intervals of time, and so it is called the non-uniform motion. So Amar and Anthony, they have covered equal distances in equal time intervals. Now you have seen this example of Amar, Akbar and Anthony. If such table is asked in your examination also, in this type question also can be asked, who is having uniform motion, who is not having uniform motion, accordingly also question can be asked. So we have seen that Amar and Anthony, they are moving with uniform speed, but Akbar is not moving with uniform speed. So write down these definitions: uniform motion and non-uniform motion. That is the linear motion. Linear means along the line, means straight line, straight forward in that way. Uniform motion, if an object covers equal distances in equal time intervals, then it is called, or it is said to be moving with uniform speed. And if it is not so, you don't have to write in this way, but you have to write the correct definition, non-uniform motion. If an object covers unequal distances, just like Akbar, see, 18, 36, then 42, then 70, what is the difference that you can see? It is not uniform difference. Unequal distances in equal time intervals, it is said to be moving with uniform speed, non-uniform speed. Uniform speed. So here in this example, if you are asked the question, who is moving with uniform speed, you can tell Amar and Anthony, they are moving with uniform speed. Now you can have very much examples for this, or you can take, suppose you are coming on the bicycle to the school and there is slow, so uniform motion you are having. If there are so many pits on the road, or in this monsoon, we cannot understand how the pit is, what is the water there, will the speed be same or uniform? No, not at all difference, because there are so many pits, there is water somewhere, and you cannot move with uniform speed. But road is straight, etc., and then you can move with uniform speed. But on the heavy crowded road, there are signals, etc., you have to stop, you have to go slow, you have to again increase the speed, means you are not moving with the uniform speed. So many examples you can take accordingly. So on the crowded road, heavy traffic road, the speed will not be uniform, the speed will be non-uniform. As speed changes, velocity changes. As direction changes, velocity changes. If both change, velocity also changes. Now that change in velocity changing, if suppose during the time, that change in velocity with respect to time, that is called the acceleration. Now one more new concept: the rate of change of velocity is acceleration. All these definitions you have to study and write the definitions, laws when asked in the examination as per given in the books, so that you cannot change the laws, regulations, etc., the laws and the definitions as it is, you have to write. So the rate of change of velocity is acceleration. So acceleration formula is change in velocity upon time. Now change in velocity, you have played the slides in the past, how you are going, you are cl- climbing the slide by the stairs and then you are sliding down. What happens? Initially, your velocity or your speed is zero. Then you are sliding down. Then slowly the speed increases. Again, you are coming down. Then what happens? Speed becomes zero. Initially, your speed is zero. Finally, when you come to the ground, then speed also zero. But in between that, on the slide, when you are sliding from the slide, then your speed increases. That you know, you everybody has played that slide and you can understand how the speed increases, how the velocity increases. Now, final velocity. So, change in velocity, final velocity minus initial velocity. What is final velocity? When we are coming down. And then initial velocity, initial minus initial velocity. You have to always remember now, change in velocity you have to calculate by subtracting the initial velocity from final velocity. Hereafter, the symbol for acceleration is A. A means acceleration, you have to remember. V is written for final velocity, U is written for initial velocity, and T for time. So A is equal to V minus U upon time. This formula you have to remember to solve the problems. Means numericals you have to solve, and then you have to remember this formula. A means acceleration, V means final velocity, U means initial velocity, and T is time. So you can calculate the change in velocity divided by time, that is called the acceleration. Now, as you have seen, the speed is uniform speed and non-uniform speed also. Similarly, acceleration is also uniform and non-uniform acceleration. In that you have seen, in equal intervals of time, suppose the speed is covered, distance covered is same, then you can say it is in uniform speed. Here also, uniform acceleration, if the velocity changes by equal amounts in equal time intervals, velocity also is changing, and because rate of change of velocity is the acceleration, and that change in velocity is in equal amounts in equal time intervals, then it is called the uniform acceleration. And opposite to that, if the rate of change of velocity is non-uniform or it is not same in equal intervals of time, then you can say it is the non-uniform acceleration. Uniform and non-uniform acceleration, these also definitions can be asked. Now, there are three more concepts, that is positive acceleration, negative acceleration, and zero acceleration. You are going by the vehicle or bicycle whatsoever maybe, and with continuous speed, continuous velocity you are going, there is no change in velocity, or your velocity is increasing according to the time, means velocity increases, then it is called the positive acceleration. Then acceleration also increases as you are changing your velocity, means acceleration is also changing, and so that change in acceleration, velocity increases, acceleration also increases, and that is called the positive acceleration. Means here your motion is in the direction of the velocity or in the direction of the speed, that is called the positive acceleration. Then negative acceleration, it is also called the deceleration. It also can be asked for the filling the blanks. Negative acceleration is called dash, it's called deceleration. Here velocity decreases with time, time is increasing and velocity is decreasing, then you can say that it is the negative acceleration. And here the velocity is in the opposite direction, or acceleration is in the opposite direction of the velocity. Suppose you can have examples, when you suddenly apply the brakes of the vehicles, suddenly the vehicle comes somewhat behind, and that is called the negative acceleration, and then zero acceleration. Here in this case, motion of the vehicle or motion of the object is in the direction, opposite direction of the velocity, that is called the negative acceleration or deceleration. Zero acceleration. Zero acceleration means velocity does not change. Constant velocity is there. Velocity is not changing at all when you are, or any object when it is moving. and then it is called the zero acceleration. Velocity does not change with time, that is called the zero acceleration. Here we'll stop.